Hi there, this is Ranjit and welcome to GeekyRanjit Explains. And as you can see, I'm not in my regular setup, sort of traveling, but again, wanted to post this GeekyRanjit Explains video. So again, guys, if the quality is not that great and the audio is not that great, please bear with me. But I just wanted to post a very quick video regarding processor heating and throttling. I've been getting a lot of questions regarding processors, and many of you actually ask, for example, this particular device has the same Snapdragon chipset, but the performance is very different, and the other device is heating. Why is it? And these things, I'm going to explain why this happens and what is processor throttling and processor heating. First, and again, this is mostly applicable both to mobile processors as well as desktop processors like Intel processors and AMD processors, but mostly I'll be concentrating on mobile processors. And every processor actually heats up when you use it, but again, think of this as your bike. Your bike has an engine. Think of the engine as the processor. With your bike, for example, if you are driving it at a speed of about 40 to 60 kilometers per hour, it runs really smooth and well. The same thing is with the processor. Yeah, you can run your bike at the highest speed possible. That's about 110 to 120 kilometers. But again, you can't continuously run at that speed for a very long time because your bike engine will heat up. The same thing is actually applicable even to processors. Again, you see the clock frequencies of processor. For example, let's take the example of the Snapdragon 821 chipset, and it's available in two variants. One is clocked at 2.1 gigahertz and the other is clocked at 2.35 gigahertz. For example, the popular OnePlus 3T is using the 2.35 gigahertz clock variation, whereas the Google Pixel uses the 2.1 gigahertz clock speed. And you might ask why. And again, if you've seen my gaming review also, the OnePlus 3T actually heats up quite a bit with extended gaming, but that was not the case with the Pixel. So OnePlus 3 went with that higher clock speed. It gives an edge, but again, there are some trade-offs also. Pixel went with the 2.1 gigahertz speed. That's clocked slightly lower, but that helps in getting better battery life. Generally, if a processor is clocked at a higher speed, it will consume a lot more power. So again, there's a trade-off. Again, these Qualcomm sells their processor in different variants. It's up to the manufacturers to actually select what clock frequencies they want. And apart from that also, they can tweak the characteristics of the processor with the kernel that they are using on their smartphones. For example, there is something known as, and I get this question a lot, Ranjit, I'm continuously using my smartphone, it's getting hot, will the processor melt or something like that? Nothing like that will happen because all modern processors, even mobile processors and desktop processors, have thermal limits. If the processor is overheating, the processor will actually shut down itself, so the melting issue won't happen. But again, even with mobile processors, you actually use them handheld. So after a certain point, for example, generally I've seen, because India is a hot country, when the temperatures go above 44 to 45 degrees centigrade, these are surface temperatures, guys, not the actual temperature that is on the processor. The processor will be running a lot higher temperature, but this is the temperature that I'm talking, that you'll feel on your hand. That is known as the surface temperature. And generally, if it goes above 44 degrees to 45 degrees centigrade, it starts to get uncomfortable. That's the thing that I show in my gaming test. When you notice with that heat gun, that is showing you the surface temperature, not the internal temperature of the processor. The internal temperature of the processor is a lot higher. You don't have to worry about that because there are thresholds. If it is heating too much, it'll like throttle down. What is throttling down? Let's say now the processor is noticing that it's getting very hot. So instead of running at, let's say the speed is 2.1 gigahertz, it'll lower it down to, let's say, about 1.4 gigahertz. This is done automatically inside. There are ways to actually control it using the kernel also. I won't get into that details. We'll talk about those details in a different part of a video. Maybe if you guys are interested, I can make another video about it. But it lowers down so that it does not heat up that much. And that is the reason sometimes you notice that. For example, this is the classic example. Recently, I encountered this. For example, the CoolPad Cool One that runs on the Snapdragon 652 SoC. If you've seen my gaming review, After about 10 minutes of gaming, that processor was reaching surface temperatures, not internal, surface temperatures of about 48 degrees centigrade, which is actually very uncomfortable. As I've told you, above 44 to 45, it starts getting very uncomfortable. The reason was that, it was also lagging with Asphalt 8 quite a bit. If you notice, recently I reviewed, what was that? The Samsung Galaxy C9 Pro, which is running on the Snapdragon 653 chipset. It ran all those games fine, I would say. And even after extended gaming, the temperatures didn't go above 39 degrees Celsius. And why was this happening? I feel Samsung did a better job at optimizing the processor and the frequencies at which it is running. That was simply Coolpad didn't do a very good job. That's why I've noticed that if a particular smartphone is having the same chipset, let's say 650, 650, one brand and the other brand, when you really push those phones, for example, in gaming and other stuff, the performance that you will get is very different. One processor might run it very well, the other might lag or get heated up. So it's up to the tuning that these OEMs do. And that differentiates the actual performance that you are seeing. And this will also affect the battery life. Generally, as I've mentioned, if the OEM allows the processor to run at a very high clock frequency, generally it will drain the battery quite a bit. But let's say if it's running at 2.1 always, no processor will generally run at the maximum clock speed. There are low power calls also for general browsing, and you're just seeing your text message and stuff. It doesn't need to run at the highest clock frequency. It generally runs at the lower clock frequency. So this is the optimization that these OEMs can actually tweak a little bit with the kernel. So that is also important, and that's the main reason I get this question. This XYZZ brand is also using the same chipset, but the performance is very different. That's the reason. So that's the main thing. I generally don't like doing gaming reviews, but with a gaming review, we actually stress the processor. There you can see the differences. So that is one thing. And moving to thermal dissipation, every processor will generate heat when it's used. But again, how a smartphone dissipates that heat is also very important. And these days, generally, we find most of the smartphones coming with metal back or aluminum back, and that really helps. You'll notice many, and I get this complaint a lot, because earlier most of the phones were using that plastic or polycarbonate back, and they never used to heat up that much when you used to touch. Only one portion used to get heated up very much near the camera. But the general body used to never get heated up. But with the metal phones, if you have used any recent metal phone, you'll notice that the entire back sort of gets heated up, because the entire back is sort of acting like a heat sink. So you might feel it's getting a lot warmer, but it's actually dissipating the heat. So these things also affect the performance of the processor, because as I've told you, classic example of your bike. If your bike is continuously running at the highest speed, after some time, the performance will go down. That's the same case with the processor. That is known as processor throttling. And again, this also is true for the GPU, that's the graphic processor unit. And generally, many people talk about that. Let's say if your smartphone is having a 1080p screen, that means almost 2 million pixels it has to push. Let's say if your same smartphone with another brand is having a quad HD screen, that puts a lot more load on the processor, because the GPU has to work twice harder to push those double amount of pixels. Generally, that's why many of the smartphones these days, you have seen, they go with 1080p screens. And again, it depends. I feel a balance of good power and processor is ideally we should look at. And recently, the Snapdragon 625 chipset, I would say, is one of the most balanced processor that I have seen for mobile smartphones. The Snapdragon 625, the advantage that it has, it's built on the 14 nanometer process. We'll talk about the processes and stuff in another video, otherwise this video will become too long. But the other good thing is that the processor does not heat up that much. And the battery efficiency is also very good. And for displays up to 1080p, the Snapdragon 625 chipset actually performs very well. That's the main reason that we are seeing the Snapdragon 625 chipset in many of the newer smartphones, because it's a very balanced processor for displays up to 1080p. So I hope this video gives you a better understanding of processor heating and throttling and why it happens, and the reason why, let's say, a particular brand might be running the same chipset, the performance actually might be a lot different. So again, guys, I hope you found this video helpful. Again, if you have any other topics for GeekyRanjit Explains, do post your suggestions in the YouTube section below. And if you're not subscribed to my YouTube channel, hit that subscribe button and also click that bell link, because now if you don't click that bell link, you won't get notified when I post a new video. So guys, that's it for now. Thanks for watching. This is Ranjit, and I hope to see you in my next video.